First, I would really like to welcome all the teachers, principals from CBSE schools, from tribal schools, for joining this awareness initiative on Innovation Ambassador. So before getting into the details of this program, I have a small presentation, about 6-7 slides, not more than that, to elaborate about what we are trying to do here and how it will be beneficial to all the teachers and CBSE schools in long run, considering Atmanirbhar Bharat initiative, considering 5 aim of India to emerge as $5 trillion economy, and eventually emerge as knowledge-based society, knowledge-based economy, thus making us the Jagat Gurus, which we all are aiming for. So let me share the presentation. Whether it's visible?
Yes, sir. It's visible, sir. You can proceed, sir.
So we are a small group, a newly formed unit, which we are called as MOE's Innovation Cell at AICT. We are supported by AICT as well as from Ministry of Education to take our projects forward. And the primary agenda of Ministry of Innovation's Education Cell at AICT is to drive innovation, is to drive entrepreneurship, drive startup activities, drive ideation across all educational institutes in India. Initially, we started with higher educational institutes, technical colleges, universities, you know, then science colleges. And now we wish to focus on schools. And the reason we want to focus on schools is because the young kids which are coming out of from school system, which enter into higher education system, need to be nurtured differently. Their out-of-box ability, thinking ability, needs to be promoted, needs to be handholded, needs to be supported. And for that, we believe that this Innovation Ambassador program, which we are going to launch, is going to be very, very critical. But before getting into these discussions, I would like to share with you a small story. We all like stories and we all like exciting stories. And I'm going to share with you a story, a real story of two kids, Yuvraj Bharadwaj and Yashraj Bharadwaj, and how they have changed their fortune while they were in schools. So these two young prodigies, young kids, actually filed their first patent when they were in 8th standard. They came up with an idea, they saw a problem related to water purification. They thought about it, they got carried away, they felt very enthused. And they felt that they have to do something about it. So they come up with a newer novel technology. You know, there are a large number of companies in this world which are working on water purification. But these two young kids, they thought differently. They started thinking about it in 6th standard. And by 8th standard, they had their patent. And in 9th standard, they actually sold their patent for $1 million. They earned 7.5 crore while they were in 8th, 9th standard. And in this entire journey, they were supported by their schools enormously. They were supported by their teachers enormously. They actually registered their startup when they were in 7th standard. And the school actually gave them a small space within their campus to establish their office. I have done a very, very elaborate interview with Yashraj Bharadwaj, and I have uploaded it on my channel, YouTube channel, Abhay Jare. I did it about a year back because I wanted to motivate youngsters during last pandemic, first lockdown I did it. I will request you all to go ahead and see this video. What we can do, what our youngsters can do. And now these kids are just 19 years old. They already have offices in 4 countries, including China. Their head office is in Dubai, Burj Khalifa. They don't come from any entrepreneurial background. They don't have any entrepreneurial background. They come from middle-class background. And now they are doing a multi-million dollar businesses. They are employing scientists with them. And that number is more than 100. So they were actually ranked by Times Group, I think, as most, Forbes Group, sorry, as amongst the 30 years, below 30 most influential people. And their story is extremely encouraging. And I will request you all once again to look at their story. And what we wish to do through this Innovation Ambassador Program is to create people like Yashraj and Yuvraj Bharadwaj in all schools of our country, because we have great talent and we really need to ensure that we nurture that talent, we take their ideas forward. Because currently, when we look at schools, they are chasing marks, they are chasing grades, they are chasing result. You know, we had 100% pass result. We had so many students in board. That mindset needs to change a bit. Now, apart from chasing marks and grades, we will chase new ideas. We will nurture kids which will have great ideas, which can be converted into startups, which can create wealth for this country, and eventually jobs for others, as these people have done, because they are now employing scientists. And if we have to create that kind of a culture within our organizations, then we need to have teachers with right mindsets, with right training. And from that perspective, we have conceptualized this Innovation Ambassador Program for our teachers, because they are going to be our on-ground change agents who are helping us, or who will help us in nurturing the kids the way we want them. More importantly, we are going to call these ambassadors as MOE's Innovation School Ambassadors. And we will be working with them continuously. We have created portals for it. And we will be hand-holding and supporting them in every possible manner, so that any great idea in any of the schools doesn't die. Because usually what we have learned and what we have seen is that many times great ideas are killed by parents and relatives at home, and maybe by some teachers in school. They don't do it knowingly. They end up doing it unknowingly. It's not a deliberate attempt. But they once someone talks about something different, they tell, "Idhar udhar ki baat mat kar, abhi tere ko kitne marks mile wo dekh. Focus, study hard." You know? But in all this, the great idea gets killed. So we have to change our mindset. We have to change our inclination. We have to change our outlook. And we believe that this Innovation Ambassador Program is going to help us do that. So in this Innovation Ambassador Program, this is the batch we will be eventually giving you. The people who will complete this Innovation Ambassador training, the badge is there on this side where you can go and actually create a metal badge out of it and wear on your chest or your shirt, you know, or your sari or your dress. But for them to get this badge, you need to complete 5 modules. The first and most important module is design thinking module. How to think, you know? It's very, very important. How to identify problems around us. Sometimes we end up living with the problems. But if we have right approach, then we will not only identify the problems, we will also find solutions. So how to think is extremely critical, and that's where the design thinking comes into picture. Design thinking is not about the design, you know, it's not about art, but it's about how to think. This helps in developing the problem-solving capabilities of our students, because we need to ensure that the problem-solving capabilities of our kids are really high. They are in par with international grade, because current analysis and internally Ministry of Education and AICT has done a study where they found that the problem solving abilities of our students coming out of our school systems is not so great. This is mainly because of the swallow and vomit kind of things which we are used to, the spoon feeding which we are used to, but we have to get out of it. So this is going to be one of the most important module of design thinking and innovation. How to think, how to identify a solution, how to solve a problem. Then another module is going to be on idea generation, how to generate ideas. And if we generate good ideas, then how to handhold those ideas. And here the role of teacher is going to be extremely critical, because students are going to come out with very crude ideas, and you have to nurture them. You have to take them forward. You have to give them right shape. Then the third module is going to be on intellectual property, patent filing, copyright issues, trademarks. Many of the teachers are not completely aware of any of these things. We really need to increase our intellectual property. China files 15 lakh patents a year. India files only 45,000, 50,000 patents. We are way behind China. So we really need to change that. And we want to ensure that large number of intellectual property actually gets generated from our school kids, because they are capable of doing that. But how to go about it? How to file it? What is the method? What are the charges? What are the forms which you really need to fill? How to write a claim? These are going to be very, very important things. So this module is really going to cover that. Then how to develop a prototype or a product? What design engineering aspects should come into it? What ergonomics? What material? How you should go about it using your laboratories, or you can collaborate with adjacent engineering college. You know, all these things are going to be in the fourth module. And final module is going to related to finance. Because if you have to do startup, who pays for it? What is going to be your customer? What is Series A funding? What is Series B funding? Because what we believe is that when students and teachers will work simultaneously, many of the startups are going to come out of the system. Teachers will have their own startups. They will play a very, very active role. And for them, they should know what is Series A funding, what is angel investors, what are venture capitalists, what they look at when they fund some of these things. Okay? So these are going to be very, very important modules. Never ever in the history has done before, where such large scale teachers are trained on such varied modules. We are planning to train about 50,000 teachers. We currently have registration from 28,000 teachers, and we want to use this opportunity to reach out to you all to go ahead and register for this program, because this program is going to be a completely different experience for you. You will learn different things which you have never learned before. It will open a different gates for you, because eventually some of you will end up becoming entrepreneurs. Some of you will end up becoming people who have their own startups along with students. And there cannot be a better thing for this country if large number of teachers and students come up with a way where they are generating wealth and giving knowledge. You know, doing both the things simultaneously, pursuing Lakshmi and pursuing Saraswati simultaneously. There cannot be better situation for us all. So we believe that together you will join us in big way. These are the platforms which we have developed. So we will be monitoring, we will be working with you, we will be handholding you in big way, so that you become successful. And we generate IPs, we generate startups, as I said, in big way. Thank you, Ellen. Thanks for giving me this opportunity. I hope I have not overshooted the time allocated to me, because there are a large number of speakers after me. But I will be there even after this program. We will continue if you have questions, and I will take some questions and I will answer them. So be there till the end if you want to continue this interaction further. Thank you very much. Namaskar.
First of all, it's a wonderful time. It's a wonderful opportunity. In fact, when Sri Manoj Ahujaji and Professor Anil Sathbuddheji joining hands all together, complete education of the country, it is coming on a common platform. During 2004 to 2010, I was principal of one of the government engineering colleges. That was in Bikaner in a desert. Huge infrastructure we had. And I was planning that time. In 2008, I was having dream, can I start a school in my higher educational, this technical institute? And I put that proposal to minister, state government in education. But probably maybe some difficulties they may be facing. They are not given that opportunity to me to connect that school education with higher education. But today I'm very lucky that I'm having the leadership in the form of Professor Anil Sathbuddheji, who is giving autonomy, in fact, connecting schools, and wonderful team in the form of Dr. Abhay Zere, just like left and right hand of AICT. Right hand, Dr. Abhay Zere, left hand, our Indian knowledge system, both are there. So this connect will be a strong initiative in the country, and the dream which national education policy is having, our students should be something different. They should be, their role should be in alignment with expectation of the society. They should be socially relevant. They should be technically sound. They should be professionally competent, and their outcome should be for the betterment of the society. And the changes which are there in national education policy, that is, the students should be vibrant, they should be able to think, they should be able to plan, they should be able to deliver, they should be able to produce. And for the betterment of the country, they should be able to contribute. That dream is getting fulfilled in the national education policy. Now school education is for 15 years. Earlier it was for 12 years. In 15 years, the dream which Abhay Zere is having, that the student should become problem solver, and that seed should be started from the school education itself. Now our secondary education is for 4 years, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th. Great autonomy students will be having, great subject, many subjects they can choose. And with that confidence, when they'll be entering into higher education, that sort of alignment is most important. Abhay, one assignment I'm giving to you. Your dream is to have 10,000 patents from academic institutes. The patent should start from school education. The example already you have given in the form of Bhardwaj brothers. I'm saying the total number of patents which you are dreaming for 10,000. Out of 10,000, I'm dreaming 10% from school education, 20% from UG level courses which are there, 30% from our PG programs, M.Tech level, 40% from our PhD. That way your dream will be fulfilled. Next slide. the Bloom's taxonomy concept, where Abhya is concentrating. Abhya is not concentrating on remembering, understanding, and applying that knowledge. It is just remembering capabilities. We are asking how many wheels car is having. Students are replying 4 wheels. We are giving 10 out of 10. Abhya is saying, don't ask those type of questions. You ask why 4 wheels are there. Why not 3? Why not 2? The questions which are unfamiliar, the questions which are non-conventional, the questions which are for the betterment of the society, you please ask those type of questions. That is termed as HOTS, higher order thinking skills. That it has to be created. It may be critical thinking, it may be creative thinking, it may be system creative thinking, it may be design thinking. There may be 10, 15, 20 attributes of that one, and for that purpose, you are keeping some 26 hours training for these ambassadors, which will be coming from schools. And that type of mindset, it will be created in the minds of the students. One example you are giving of Stanford University, that assignment which you are given, according to their report, there are 2 skills in fact students are having. One is academic skills, where we are giving marks, the conventional examination system we are having. Another one is high order thinking skills, where unconventional problems we are giving in the form of Smart India Hackathon. The students are providing the solution, but they are unconventional. They are not familiar with those problems. First time it is coming in the form of those problems, and students are providing the solution. So what Stanford University, when they are entered into our schools and into our higher education institutes, they are saying in academic skills, in conventional teaching which we are doing, conventional examination which we are doing, in that case, particularly in first year and second year of engineering, our students are comparable with Russian students in academic skills, I am saying. I'm not saying high order thinking skills, comparable with Russian students, but lesser than Chinese students, even in academic skills. But as far as high order thinking skills are concerned, in that case, they are inferior as compared to Chinese and Russian students. So their suggestions are, at higher level, they'll be doing wonders. If at school level, that foundation we can make stronger. So it is a wonderful time connecting higher education with schools and finally with industries. It is a wonderful, wonderful initiative. And probably when school level, it will be improved. At higher level, also the fruits which we'll be getting, that will be much stronger fruits. In our national education policy, there is a talk about autonomy, improving the practical knowledge of these students, even from class 6, provision of internship, it has been kept. The assessment should be on the basis of outcomes, what exactly students are able to do, not on the basis of what they are capable to remember, but on the ground, what they are able to do, that it has to be tested. And innovation and critical thinking, it has to be started from school education, from class 6 itself, and not only from class 6, from foundation itself, from preparatory phase, where they are doing, from middle school, from secondary school, everywhere that sort of environment it has to be. And the prominent areas, the emerging areas which are coming, where industry demands are changing, industry 4, artificial intelligence, data sciences, cyber security, robotics, those sort of subjects at the school level it has been started. But who will impart training to those teachers? Certainly the expertise which higher educational institutes are having, that connect it has to be established, and that we have done in fact. The connect of school teachers with higher educational institute teachers for bringing that sort of knowledge in the minds of the teachers related to industry 4, then internship component. I am saying internship of the school students can be in our higher educational institutes. It can become just like a hospital in the case of medical education, which is there. In medical education, morning students are attending academic classes, evening they are coming in the hospitals and they are treating the patients. And even the latest diseases they are treating. Today COVID is there, they are treating COVID. But in our case, that sort of connect is not there. Now school education, if we can connect with higher education institutes with industries, if that connect can be established, probably majority of the problem will be sorted out. Our friends will be technically sound, they'll be professionally competent, and they should be socially relevant. That connect exactly we want through these type of initiatives we have done and the MOU which we have signed. Next one. And the students who are coming out from our institutes, industries are putting lot of blames in fact. They are saying your students are not creative, they are unable to solve the problem, they are not connected to our organization, their communication skills are weak, their attitude is not towards our industries, they are not taking ownership, they are not taking responsibility. So many suggestions they are giving. Once they have gone out from our academic institutes, if some suggestions are coming, there is no use. If when students are inside the institute, if some suggestions are coming, certainly corrective measures will be able to take. The industries are saying at the end of 4 years of engineering degree, you are giving one mark sheet. In that mark sheet, CGPA is written. they are saying we are not interested in CGPA. We are interested what your friends are able to do, how they can plan, how they can deliver, how they can do some innovation in our organization, how they can manage time, how they can manage team, how they can give leadership. So many suggestions they are giving, and they want those type of students who are all around us, in fact. Next one. Many initiatives AIC have taken during last 4 years. We have changed the curriculum according to needs of the industry. Teachers training, we have started mandatory pedagogical training for the teachers, students induction program for 21 days. Once they are entering into higher academic institute, there should not be any gap. In fact, the understanding of that higher academic institute during those 21 days, friendship with the teacher, friendship with the laboratories, friendship with peer, that will be creating in students induction program. Mandatory internship policy we are having. Then we are having 5 MOs with the industries and that innovation share. And to these teachers, I'm saying, who are in these schools, I'm saying in technical institutes, we are having capacity to accommodate 32 lakh students every year. The population of Singapore is less than 32 lakhs. In our technical institute, that much space is available. Please orient your students in such a way so that they can take the benefit of the infrastructure which has been created by Government of India or our private partners. They can take the benefit of this one. Lot of scope. Next one, 10,000 institutes we are having, which are being regulated by All India Council for Technical Education. Next one. We are having, next one. Helen, next one. We are having 10,000 plus institutes which are governed by All India Council for Technical Education, where 261 type of UG program in 26 major disciplines. We are having 6 lakh teachers to teach our students. We are having 23 IITs, 31 NITs, triple IITs.
Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, it's clear. It's clear. Lot of scope for students are available. Next one. Ellen aligns with me. You come next.
So I believe it is some kind of technology there, and yeah, it must be screen must have been freezed, and now they are trying to.
Yes, sir. It seems some problem is there.
Yes, sir. Ellen, Ajay, are you guys sorting it out?
Yes, sir. I think it's a problem from Ellen's side.
Yeah, no. I have shared the system. Can you hear me?
It is not coming. Content is not visible, okay. Sir. Can you just stop sharing and start again, sir?
Sure. I'm doing it. Once again, I'm doing
it. Yeah. So from here, yes. So induction program of 21 days we have started, where students are familiarizing with the system of the academic institute. Many prominent people from outside, they are coming, they are delivering lectures. Even some proficiency gaps are there, that is also being fulfilled. So lot of help to the students are being given. Next one. We are having this huge internship portal. This internship portal can be used for school students also. So whatever AICT is having, we are ready to share with our school education, so that benefit they can take. Thousands of industries are registered on this one. Students can register for the purpose of taking internship, even for personalized learning concept, which is the key part of national education policy. We are having one portal in the name of National Education Alliance for Technologies, where 15 different baskets are there. In the form of learning games, in the form of coding skills, improving their coding skills. The concept of artificial intelligence is available on that portal, and it can take care of the personal capabilities of the students in what way they are learning. So effective learning is possible through this NEET portal. This can also be extended in time to come for the purpose of school students. And on that portal, 25% coupon, they are private ed tech companies, they are charging, in fact, some fee they are having. But for 25% coupons they are providing to All India Council for Technical Education for socially weaker section. We are having learning assessment mechanism just like the Stanford University, which they have done in the same fashion we are starting now. So first year students, when they are coming to us, their abilities related to math, physics and chemistry, how they are able to apply that knowledge. After that one, their core skills as well as aptitude, we are testing. If some gaps are there, then the corrective measures are being taken that time itself. Then the changes in teaching learning processes or changes in curriculum or the some infrastructure help, additional infrastructure help is needed or computation facilities are needed. So that sort of corrective measures institutes can take. Next one. This benefit schools again can take, as we are having connect of our higher educational institutes with school teachers, and we are having Atal academies who are providing training to school teachers. And particularly in these emerging areas, we have started with robotics and artificial intelligence. Probably in time to come, even for coding skills, again, it is a key part of new education policy for school education. So in those areas also, our connect can be established. And in Atal Academy, most of the IITs and NITs teachers are taking those training sessions. In fact, last year, we could train around 1.5 lakh teachers in the country. And employability enhancement, due to the initiatives which we people have taken, majority of the expectations which NEP is having, we have started from 2017. Our leadership, visionary leadership, they could expect that time that these many changes will be coming through national education policy, and many initiatives we have taken, and lot of changes are coming in the mindset of these students. Some 30 years back, students were just dreaming to go to US. Their dream was to see how US looks like, but many adults were there. Foremost hurdle was how much they will be bringing dollars, how visa will be created. Now government of India is giving lot of facilities. Money is not the constraint. And now the students who are going, not today, some 20 years back, they have started going for earning these degrees, different level of degrees, M.Tech, PhD program. So earlier they were dreaming just to go to US. After that, they started taking degrees. Third stage came when Indian students started to become CEOs of many of the prominent organizations in the world, dominating organization. That was dream even 10 years before. And now the dream which Indian students are having, that is, we should become CEOs of our Indian companies. Microsoft, Google should be created here itself. The birth of these type of institute should be from our academic institute. And that dream our students are having. So the connect which we are having, schools and higher education institute, basically to fulfill this dream. And the example of Yasraj Bajwa's, which Abhay was giving, that was this type of example. Many of startups in last 10 years, five, 6 years, it has come and it is increasing our GDP. These are the example of the startups which has been created by these youth in the country. The concept which we would like to bring, probably Chairman Saab will be refining this one. I'm saying our institution innovation councils, Abhay, please listen. In higher education institutes, you are having India in this institution innovation councils. It is in around 2,500 institutes you are having. We would like to connect this one with students, and we'll be saying it will be idea generation clinic for this student. Clinic word probably Chairman Saab will be redefining this one. I'm saying it should be idea generation clinic, your institute innovation councils. Our engineering institution should become internship cleaning, hands-on experiences related to technology, related to internship. For vocational education in school also, it is an important part. We are saying our polytechnic and ITI should become vocational clinics. That sort of help those people should extend to our school students. And our idea lab, which our MSRB is saying today, we have given 50 idea lab financial support. In time to come, in most of the prominent institutes, we'll be having idea lab. We'll be giving and we'll be naming this one as product development clinic. Idea lab, product development clinic, and finally our IITs and NITs, research and IP clinic. The 10,000 target which we are having, if this sort of connect we can establish, probably whatever you are dreaming, your dream will be fulfilled. The same dream is of our Honorable Education Minister, that quality-based education with values, it has to be. And that positive dent throughout the globe, it has to be created by our young population. And Honorable Prime Minister of India is saying that everyone should become Atmanirbhar, skilled India, confident youth. That dream Honorable Prime Minister of India is having. If all sort of hand-holding we are doing, what we are planning today, probably that dream of Honorable Prime Minister will be fulfilled. Thank you very much for this wonderful day. I'm extending my best wishes to everyone.